The berimbau is one member of a really large family of instruments that come from sub-Saharan Africa and into Brazil.
It's a very simple instrument. There are not that many pitches that you can get on either side of the wire. There's only maybe two or three, sometimes four possibilities on either side.
It allows a kind of a freedom or a kind of a dance that is really provocative and evocative of, again, I think a human well-being. Our mission as an organization is to bring joy to the world through the berimbau, to spread the joy of what that instrument has to offer, particularly here in the United States where it's very little known.
So every time that we perform live, there are always people who are saying, oh my gosh, I've heard your music before. It's completely different when I see it live because of the just what the instrument looks like, how we are passing lines between each other, how we're using the instrument in as many ways as possible, again, to just kind of build on the vocabulary that's available to us on that instrument.
One of the beautiful things about percussion is that the physical activity of playing percussion is very readable by an audience. And just about everyone in the audience can relate to percussion movements, whether you're hitting something or scraping something or caressing something. And so with that in mind, we thought it was really essential to demonstrate the sounds that we're making to our audiences. And there's no medium that can convey that as well in audio alone.
So the videos are really, the listening is the first level of really understanding what's going on, but the videos add so much to it, and I think it adds a lot of joy when listening to it too, because it's like this unexpected pleasure of seeing what the instruments can do.
The pastoral nature of Elliot Cole's Hoda, and in particular Elliot's spirit coming through the piece, is so gentle, so inviting, and so natural that we really felt it was critical to demonstrate his piece, to set it in an outdoor, in a natural environment. We had chosen specific places where we thought would really demonstrate and highlight the natural beauty of the American Midwest. We went out to double check on the space and to show Elliot the spaces, and we realized that in the golden hour of the evening, which is what Elliot had requested for the setting of his piece, the river that we had chosen, the bridge over the river that we had chosen, was surrounded by trees, and those trees were blocking the light. So in an exhilarating drive around the countryside, we scouted out some other places and found this really beautiful prairie in a forest preserve.
I guess with my piece, I guess aesthetically it sounds different than anything else. It would seem out of place to be in a completely natural environment. I thought the space that a hangar has, you know, kind of, it could feel big, it could feel small, it can, I guess in a sense that it's like empty and there's a lot of space, but so I thought that would work for my piece really well.
Kyle, bless his heart, found this incredible airport hangar in DeKalb that we had no idea existed and had no problem walking right in and just asking if it would be possible to shoot there. And I have to say that last night's shoot of his trio turned out to be just remarkably special from a visual standpoint, beyond my mildest imaginations. Once again, the magic that 410 Media is able to conjure within a given space was just incredible. We walked away feeling very satisfied, I think, after last night's shoot.
It's a different experience when we play these pieces to record for videos versus when we play these pieces to record in the studio. I think each experience in our performances reveal different things about the pieces, and you start to, you know, have a more like intimate understanding of what each piece is and the aesthetics behind each piece. I think it just reveals a lot of extra like emotion behind each of the pieces, which is really fun.